So we are here with Reggie Jackson. Now, you just finished with Piers, and, you know, that being said, for Piers, sports starts and ends with soccer and cricket. He probably doesn't know Mickey Mantle from Mickey Mouse. So knowing that, how did it go?
I thought it went very well. I was interested in his a little more broad, you know, perspective in reference to asking questions,
right,
from our political environment to other things that, you know, were not just about sports. So I enjoyed the conversation. I, you know, got a chance to express my, how to dance a little bit and make sure I didn't get too far into the political thing, environment. But I think I'm just like any other American that's disappointed with, you know, what's going on with our government leadership, if you will, in reference to our people that are hardworking every day and have needs. And we're not providing for those needs as a nation and not being the leader that we need to be.
That said, is it okay if I talk to you about baseball? Because that is what I'm most excited about. I was looking at the calendar this morning. It says October, so this is your month. All these years later, you still feeling good about that?
Yes, I do. I feel good about it. I'm grateful that I have the nickname and the moniker works. It's fun. I go different places, and people say, Reggie, are you going to the game? Or it's October. How do you feel? Good to see you, Mr. October. So it's nice.
Yeah. Looking at baseball now with the four teams that are left, so many good pitchers, Wainwright, Kershaw, Greinke, Verlander. From a guy who could change a game with one swing, does good pitching still beat good hitting?
I think good pitching will slow down good hitting, okay, without a doubt. But there are some guys, you know, Beltran certainly comes to mind, that, you know, he's not one of the great all-time hitters in you know, during the season, and only saying that when I mean 40 home runs and 140 RBIs and hitting 340. But when postseason comes about, Beltran is a guy that I would bet my money on, and I don't think good pitching is going to get Beltran out. I think he plays well under pressure, and I think good pitchers will give him balls to hit. That's why I think he has an opportunity to be successful, and I see the same thing with Cabrera.
Mm-hmm.
Cabrera is the best hitter of our generation right now, and one of the best hitters certainly in baseball in the last, you know, 25, 30 years. Good pitching is going to pitch to him, and he's going to hit good pitching. He's going to hit great pitching. So I think that some of your great hitters, be it a Manny Ramirez or a great DeRay, Frank Robinson, Mantle, and people like that, that rose above the vent. During times when great pitching dominated, you know, I think that the great hitters are going to be successful during this particular time. I really do.
I'm going to put you on the spot real quick. Your Yankees didn't even make the playoffs, and your beloved A's got bounced yesterday. So we have four teams left.
Why you hit me twice?
You're here. I was hoping that Oakland would still be alive so we could talk about that. But there's only four teams left. Who
you
gets
could have said, like, Reggie, you know, none of the teams you were on, you know, they didn't quite make it, but they played great. You know, take care of me a little
soften
bit.
Soften the blow a little bit.
Yeah. You didn't, none of your teams got in. You know, so not, you know, now you nothing.
But that said, who gets to the World Series and who wins it?
I am going to bet on Detroit.
Okay.
Certainly, I think the Dodgers are right there. And any of the four teams, I think the matchups are good. I think they all represent a great champion. I'm going to pick Detroit, although they do not have the best relief pitching.
Mm-hmm.
But I think they have an axe to grind. I think they're disappointed at what happened to them in the World Series last year. And, of course, they lost, you know, back a few years ago against the Cardinals. So for a bounce back and for a team that has an edge, an axe to grind, I'm going to stick with the Tigers.
And to review and to confirm, none of the teams that you played for are alive still. I wasn't sure if we got that the first time around. I just wonder if
we're going to start fighting right now.
You can catch Reggie's full interview with Piers tonight on CNN at 9 p.m.
Mr. October here.